Hi, and welcome to the next lecture part on the tuning validation test principle in tuning and nested resampling. So remember, what we want to do is we want to select an optimal configuration of a learning algorithm, but without compromising the accuracy of our performance estimation for that learner. And for that, we have discussed this untouched test set principle, right? So we are not allowed to optimize our performance on the same test that we will also later use to evaluate the generalization performance of our algorithm. And for this, to kind of algorithmically achieve this and to simulate this untouched test set principle, we can perform a super simple three-way split. So during tuning, we train. So three-way split means we take our complete data set and we split it up into now three parts: a training part, a validation part, and a testing part. And during tuning, what we will do is we will always train our learning algorithm on the training set with a specific configuration lambda. We will this training process will in a model f hat will result in a model f hat. We'll predict with this model on our validation set. That gives rise to a validation set performance, and this we will optimize with our tuning algorithm. So we'll try out more and more and different configurations lambda in a loop until our tuning budget is depleted. And after this process has stopped, we'll return the optimal model configuration lambda star and perform one final model fit with this lambda star configuration on the joint training and validation set. And now we will do one final prediction of this model with configuration lambda star on our untouched test set. And through this principle, we have used the validation data to guide our tuning search process, but we have never really touched this test set here. So our final evaluation on this test set will not be biased by continuous optimization on the test set. And in a certain sense, we could also now understand this as effectively making the tuning as part of a more complex training procedure. So you could actually see this as use the or endow the training algorithm with a first tuning step that runs our tuning algorithm through cross-validation or through validation set optimization as a first step, returns lambda star as the optimal configuration, and then with lambda star fits the learning algorithm on the complete training data set and returns our model. And this effectively removes our hyperparameters from the inputs of our learning algorithm and makes this learning algorithm in a certain sense parameterless and self-tuning. So if we view it like this, this data set here is basically now our model selection training data set, where we are running the tuning as a first step, then the optimal parameters are or the optimal hyperparameter configuration is returned, and then we do this final second training step here. So this combined training and validation set is actually the training set for the self-tuning endowed algorithm.